Equations of Lines and Planes, Level 4. In this video, we will continue going over slightly more challenging examples involving the equations of lines in space. We will go over 5 examples, so let's jump straight into the first example. Find a vector equation, parametric equations, and symmetric equations for line L that passes through the origin and is parallel to line M. In this problem, we are asked to find a vector, parametric, and symmetric equations of a line that passes through the origin and is parallel to line M. Notice that we are provided with the parametric equations of line M. We're going to use these equations and obtain the information we need in order to determine the equations for line L. In order to write the vector equation of line L, we need an initial point on the line and a vector that is parallel to line M. We already have an initial point since we are told that line L passes through the origin. So the position vector will be located at the origin, and as a result, will have no components. Now, to determine a vector parallel to line M requires us to use the parametric equations of line M. We can generate 2 random points that lie on point M by choosing 2 distinct values for the parameter t, and then finding the position vector associated with those 2 points. Alternatively, we can also just take a look at the parametric equations and find a parallel vector by inspection. Recall that the direction numbers of a parametric equation represents the components of a vector parallel to the line. In this case, the parallel vector will have components equal to 2, negative 1, and 3, or written in unit vector form as 2i minus j plus 3k. Now that we have a vector parallel to line M, we will use this vector to write the vector equation of line L. Substituting this parallel vector into the vector equation of line L, we obtain the following. Then, we go ahead and distribute the parameter t and add the vectors. Doing that, we obtain the following vector equation. Next, we find the parametric equations by isolating all 3 components of the vector equation. Doing that, we obtain the following. Lastly, we find the symmetric equations by solving for the parameter t for each parametric equation and equating them with one another. Doing that, we obtain the following symmetric equations. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's take a look at the next example. Find a vector equation, parametric equations, and symmetric equations for line L that passes through point P and is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. In this problem, we need to find a vector, parametric, and symmetric equations of a line that passes through point P and is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. For this problem, the initial position vector for line L will have components equal to the coordinates of point P, so we can start writing the vector equation with this information. Now, to determine a vector parallel to line L is going to require a little bit of work. Notice that line L is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. Recall from the previous video series that the cross product between 2 vectors generates a 3rd vector that is perpendicular to the crossed vectors. So we're going to do just that and cross vector A with vector B. If you're a little rusty with a cross product, you can always go back and refresh your memory with a cross product video series. Computing the cross product between vector A and vector B, we obtain the following vector. This vector is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. Since line L is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B, we can use this vector as the direction vector of line L. So now, it is just a matter of substituting this vector into our equation. Next, we distribute the parameter t and add the vectors component-wise. Doing that, we obtain the following vector equation in component form and as an equivalent unit vector form. The parametric equations can be obtained by separating each component into its own equation as follows. The symmetric form can be obtained by solving for the parameter t for each parametric equation and equating them to one another, obtaining the following. We can also rewrite the middle equation by distributing the negative sign to each term in the numerator, which results in the following expression. And this is our final answer. Let's take a look at the next example. Is the line through point A and point B parallel to the line through point C and point D? In this problem, we are given the coordinates of four points. One line passes through point A and point B. Another line passes through point C and point D. We are asked to determine if the first line is parallel to the second line. We can show that the two lines are parallel by finding a direction vector for each line, and then checking to see if one vector is a constant multiple of the second vector. Let's find a direction vector for the first line by subtracting the coordinates of point A from the coordinates of point B. Let's label this vector as vector V. In a similar fashion, let's find a direction vector for the second line by subtracting the coordinates of point D from the coordinates of point C. Let's label this vector as vector W. Now let's check to see if vector V is a constant multiple of vector W. We can determine this by inspection, or we can decompose the vectors into components and solve for the constant C for each component as follows. Notice that the constant C is the same for all three components. This means that vector V is equal to a constant multiple of vector W. So we conclude that the first line is indeed parallel to the second line, and this is our final answer. Let's move along to the next example. Is the line through point P and point Q perpendicular to the line through point R and point S? In this problem, we are once again given the coordinates of four points. One line passes through point P and point Q. Another line passes through point R and point S. We are asked to determine if the first line is perpendicular to the second line. We can show that the two lines are perpendicular by finding a direction vector for each line and then compute the dot product between both vectors and check to see if it is equal to zero. If the dot product is equal to zero, then the lines are perpendicular. On the other hand, if we obtain any other number, then we can conclude that the lines are not perpendicular. Let's find a direction vector for the first line by subtracting the coordinates of point P from the coordinates of point Q. Let's label this vector as vector V. In a similar fashion, let's find a direction vector for the second line by subtracting the coordinates of point R from the coordinates of point S. Let's label this vector as vector W. Now let's find the dot product between these two vectors. So we go ahead and find the product of each of the vector's components and add them. In the end, the dot product is not equal to zero, so we conclude that these two lines are not perpendicular to one another. And this is our final answer. Let's end the video with a final example. Find a vector equation for the line segment from point A to point B. In this problem, we are asked to determine a vector equation for a line segment that starts at point A and ends at point B. Recall that the vector equation for a line segment is slightly different than the vector equation of a line, mainly because a line segment has a beginning and an end. So we need to adjust the vector equation to take these endpoints into account. We also need to restrict the parameter t to be defined between 0, the first endpoint of the line segment, and 1, the second endpoint of the line segment. Recall that the vector equation of a line segment can be written as follows. Here, vector r0 represents the position vector for one endpoint, and vector r1 represents the position vector of the other endpoint. Let's use the coordinates of point A to find the components of vector r0. And use the coordinates of point B to find the components of vector r1. Substituting these position vectors into the vector equation of a line segment, we obtain the following. Now it is just a matter of simplifying the vector equation. we will first multiply vector r0 by the quantity 1 minus the parameter t. We will also multiply the parameter t with the vector r1. Then, it is just a matter of adding the vectors component-wise. Doing that, we obtain the following vector equation, where the parameter t is defined between 0 and 1 inclusive, and this is our final answer. Alright, now that we have covered examples involving the equation of lines in space, we will now shift gears and learn how to write the equation of a plane.